Hello there, coming up on the show. Very excited about this. Look, Debbie Harry is here, topping the charts for over 30 years, and we are so looking forward to be talking to her. Looks incredible. Right here in the studio, Il Divo are going to be here as well. Now then, I'm so excited. As the lead singer of iconic punk band Blondie, Debbie Harry has had more than 30 years of hits. Debbie Harry joins us live. How are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, it's
fine,
great to see you. It really is. I feel as if I've grown up with you.
You have?
Yeah, which is terrific.
Have you been fully indoctrinated?
Well, I tell you what, I did try this kind of bin bag look with the tights. Uh-huh. You looked sexy, sassy and amazing, and I looked like an idiot.
Well, it was the gloves.
The gloves were good.
The gloves always do. It's the accessories.
That make the outfit.
Right.
Exactly, you know. Absolutely. But you were always ahead of the game when it came to style and when it came to music as well. But, you know, you were saying when you first were performing, you went there and you performed, and then the next week you went back to this place and everybody was dressed like you. You know, they'd all kind of picked up on the style of you and the band.
Yeah, that was, I think, in L.A.
Mm.
That was quite early on, I guess, 1975, 76.
Yep. Yeah, it would be.
Yeah.
And I think as well for you, because you weren't really a teenager when all of this happened, you were a little bit older, did that help you deal with it? Because you'd had a life before. You know, the way that a lot of kids get flung into it when they're like maybe 17, 18, 19, and they don't have anything to sort of prepare them in a way.
I'm always amazed that, you know, when kids get famous and I'm surprised at how well they actually do. You know, they seem to come out really well. I don't know, I feel like I guess it was like a second coming, a second lifetime. You know, I had been in a group in the 60s, and the whole industry had changed so much by the time we got to the 70s. It's amazing what happens in the music industry.
You should write your book. Are you going to? You should write your autobiography. You really should. Oh, you've got to. No holds barred.
Oh.
It'd be great, though, because apart from the story of you and your life, it's the story of the whole sort of music business all the way through these, eight, you know, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, right up to today. That would be the thing. Got to get working on that.
Okay.
It's got to start. It's got to happen. I would certainly love to see that. I really would. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
I cannot believe that you're 62. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
62 years old, and look at you. It's not fair. Have you had any help? Please tell me you have.
I take advantage of every... I was going to say something, but... I take advantage of, you know, whatever is available, and
right.
I like feeling good, and I like looking good, and it's important to me. It's important to... me as an entertainer, and it's important to me just as a person.
Yeah.
You know, so
you've tried all kinds of strange things over the years, have you?
Probably. I don't know how strange they are. They seem really logical to me, yeah. But you know, I don't. I guess I have a sense of adventure. That's always served me well, so.
For sure. But you've got great cheekbones, that's the thing.
Yeah, so do you.
Now, once you've got the cheekbones, then everything else, you
that's
know.
That's right, we rule the world with cheekbones.
We do, absolutely,
right.
Absolutely. You are single at the moment, are you? You're looking for somebody?
Thinking,
yeah, it wouldn't be so bad.
You have somebody?
Because, well, I could set you up with so many people. They would be delighted. But you, for a long, long time, obviously, you and Chris from the band were together. You know, you were performing together and you were together. Still mates, though, because he's married now with a couple of kids, and you're the godmother, aren't you?
I am a godmother.
Ah.
I am a godmother so many times.
How cool would that be to have Debbie Harry as your godmother? It'd be fantastic.
That's what they think, but they're completely wrong. I'm good at gifts, and I'm good at, you know, playing around and having a good time, but I'm not good at the religious training or anything like that.
No, but that just be a really good godmother and take them shopping.
Shopping.
Oh, yeah. And buy them things.
I can do that.
That's fine. That's absolutely fine. You sort of paved the way for so many people because it was very unusual in the time for a woman to be the forefront of a band. It didn't really happen that much in the way that you were. And I guess you paved the way for people like Madonna to come along, you know, people like that. You were sort of trailblazer, I guess.
That's what they say.
Yeah, I think you were for sure. Now, there's a show in the West End, Desperately Seeking Susan, which is the movie that Madonna was in, and they're using a lot of Blondie songs in that as well, aren't they?
Yeah, it's all Blondie material, and it's I think it's going to open sometime for previews in October.
Right.
And then again, I guess the real opening is in November.
Sure. This is them rehearsing the show. So have you had a lot to do with that? Has there been a lot of input there, or have they just been using the songs?
I wrote a new song for it.
Right.
Called Moment of Truth. Chris and I wrote a song. And they're using all the catalogue.
Oh, excellent. No, it's really good.
Yeah. Surprising how good it all works.
Nice.
I mean, I was sort of, a little doubtful about musical theatre and Blondie, but it really works. And I always liked the movie. I thought it was cute.
It's a good movie.
It's fun, you know, it's fast moving. And the thing that's nice about it, too, is that it has a few dark edges to it. You know, it's a little bit, it's not like, wow, musical theatre, you
right.
know. It's contemporary, and I think it has a great feel to it.
Well, I'd imagine if it's something to do with you, there would be a wee twist there. It wouldn't be so straightforward. You know, in a good way. In a good way, Miss Debbie.
I'm pounding my chest and my microphone.
No, that's fine. You're okay. Now, look, tell me about this new album, because this is out. Is this out now, Necessary Evil? This is out as we speak?
It just came out, I think, was today Tuesday?
Yes.
It came out yesterday.
Excellent. And are you happy with it? Has it all worked out the way you thought?
Well,
it's good. No, it's good.
I mean, I don't think I would have put it out if I didn't think the music what I wanted. No, it's fun. It was a really great project for me, and it started out sort of casually, and I just had ideas, and they just evolved, and finally I had enough for an album.
Excellent. Should we have a look at the new single? Here we
please.
Go.
Please. Yes. Well, maybe I could have been better. Yeah, maybe I've been kind of bad. But I know, oh yes, I know. You'll be two times through.
That's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I love the whole sort of style of that.
Yeah,
really,
he's wonderful. Rob Ross did the video, and he's did all this animation and 3D work, and it's really nice.
Excellent. So what keeps you going? Do you still love it? Do you still enjoy it? You still love all the performing?
I love music. I love music, and I guess I'm in a rut, big rut. A big happy rut.
It's a big happy rut. Well, that's good. And what about movies? You're going to do some more film?
Yeah, I did actually. I had a little part in a film with in a film called Elegy that's directed by Isabel Crochet.
Right.
I was very happy that I had the chance to work with Sir Ben Kingsley.
Ah.
It was a very small part, my part.
But do you like doing that? Do you like doing projects that are a bit different and you're not having to sort of take the whole burden of it, but you can come in and do smaller parts and it's
great? No,
you want to be the diva, you want to be the star.
I'd love to be able to develop a character all the way through, to really take it somewhere. And, you know, it's hard to drop in on a 1 or 2 day thing. And a shoot that's been going, you know, for weeks and you drop in for 2 days, it's really, you know, you have to really run fast to catch up and sort of, you know, feel it out.
Excellent. Well, look, keep going. Great to see you.
Thank you. Really
good to see you. You look incredible. You look absolutely amazing. I know there's been a tiny, teeny, teeny bit of help, but for goodness sake, look amazing. Thank you, Debbie. It's great to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you.